functor. The functor is a function that takes a module, right? And then creates another module. So the example is a set, right? Look at the set. To create a set, in the set, what do you put? You can put string, you can put integer, whatever you put, you have to tell me how you compare, okay? As long as you tell me how you compare two items, then I can put anything in a set. So that means the set will take, look at this make function. The make function, it takes, right? Look at that, a module. The module will tell you how you compare, right? How you compare. For example, this is it. This is saying, I'm going to create a set, right? That set only takes string. So string is a module. It has a compare, right, method. You could put integer. You could put anything. But it has to be, right? It has to have a compare method. So it means this module set, if you give me another module as an argument, it will create a new module. Look at that. This string set is a module. But I created a string set using the set module, right? Look at that. Set is a module. And I will send this string as an argument for this module. And then it creates a new module called strset. If I send int, it would create like int set, for example, right? So I could create different sets based on my type, right? Based on my type. Okay, the functor is, it's a module, takes, right? It's a function that one takes another module and returns a module that we call it a functor, okay? So here's this example, right? I have this printer. It's very difficult to come up with a small example because a functor has multiple working parts. Number one, it's a printer, right? I have a printer. I can print different types of things, right? Different types of things. I have a print method, right? Anything you give me, look at that. Anything you give me, I will call toString method of that E. Look at this E. So I don't care what you give me. Anything you give me, I'll just call toString. Means the E, right? This E you give me, you must have a toString method. So look at that. Printer, I'm going to print int. This int must have a toString method. That's here. This int, it does have a toString method. It's a string of int. Instead of int, if you give me float, fine. You must have a string, toString method that's a string of float, right? String of float. So the printer method, right? Look at the printer method. If you give me int, I will print int. If you give me float, I will print float. See? Print int, print float. Yeah, works. Why? If you give me an, right? Int, then I'm going to use this int printer. It can print int. If you say float printer, it can print all the floats. So there are, I'll say that again, multiple working parts. This is number one. The printer will take another module. E is a module. C, int is a module. It takes a module, returns a module. What did it return? It returned an int printer. This is another module. Now we use that module. So the int printer is the final module that we will use. But it is created by this printer module. The printer is a module that takes int module and then returns the int printer. Okay? Int printer. In the OCaml, the map is a functor module, right? So how do you use map? Look at this map. Map, it's a key value store. You must tell me how you compare, right? How you compare. So to create the integer map, I will tell make the map function, say, hey, map, create, right? Create a module. That module is taking integer type, and compare is same as this integer comparison. That's a pervasive compare, right? So now I have a new module called intmap. Then intmap take integer as a key, right? I say add. So because I opened intmap, I can say add int 100 Alice to an empty map. So now I have keys 100, value is Alice. And then look at that. If I say find 100 from this map M1, it gives me Alice. Okay, it gives me Alice. So without this functor, you create maps for each data type, right? Integer, string, every data type, you have to create a module. Not this, right? You create this map, and then based on the struct you gave me, I will give you a new module, okay? New module. This is called a functor. I'll show you another example that is... Okay, so this is a stack. The stack, cat, stack, this is the same interface. You can empty, push, pop. This is the exact same interface. Now, my stack implementation, emacs list.stack, this stack, this is a, you know, a stack that, look at this implementation, a little overwhelming, let's say. My stack, right, takes any type. ELT is any kind of element, but that element must implement the signature called stringable. That is, you can take this and then convert into a string. Look at that. So this is the interface. Whatever you push into the stack, you must implement this. So my int item, it did implement, right? It did implement stringable because I have a toString method. My float item, it also implemented this interface, right? Because I can convert float into a string. So I have this point type. Point is like X and Y. My point item also implemented a stringable. That's how I convert toString. I should just say 1, 1, right? You should say, you know, take that X, take that Y, and convert. To make it simple, I say put 1. So now I have a stack. You could push different, you can create other stacks using those items. So here, for example, in my main function, emacs main, no window. See, this is an int stack. Look at that. I have int stack. It only takes int items. So I can push 10, 20, 30. I say, hey, dump it, right? How do you dump it? If you don't know how to convert into a string, you can't. But now I can because each of those, it has a, you know, it implemented a stringable. I can make it a string. So toString, just convert all of them to a string. Print, right? Print. That is good. Now I can do the exact same thing. That is, I can create a float stack. Look at that. This time I use the same list stack implementation, but this time give me a stack that takes floating point numbers. I can push 10.20.0, just takes floating point numbers. Now I can print that, right? This time it takes a floating point and converts into a string, right? Converts, fine. Now I can also do a point, right? This point I can push like a record of X1, 2, each record, right? And then I can also print. So now if I execute this thing, you will see, OCaml main. No, I have to compile. That's OCaml build main.byte. Yeah, it did compile. So if I execute, see, it printed the int stack, it printed a float stack, it printed a point stack. But all of these, right, this string is created by emacs list one by one function that is this function. Look at that, toString method. It takes entire each item from the stack calls toString method. It calls this method. How do you know you have this method? You know because any item you push into the stack, it is stringable. You must have toString method. So the stack, you can't just randomly push an item. It must be, right, stringable. So that is our functor, okay? The map module is exactly like that. You take a map module, you can create other kinds of maps by sending, right, by sending a struct to the functor. I'll take a question. Nobody? Wow. Good. Then let's continue. I can finish the entire semester today. You look at your phone, I do fast, then that's how we finish. I can show you another example. Yeah. What for? Just doing it fast? When you send something to make, you have to tell the type, you have to have the compare function. So one detail to make you go home and eat dinner, I skipped one simple detail. See that highlighted thing? It tells you for this stack, that item you're pushing into the stack actually comes from the type of that element. So the element has a type. If I go back to the int item, just look at that highlighted, and then now I go to the int item. See, my type t is int. That's how the map knows this is an integer or a float, because I pass that, okay? This is all the keywords are used, right? Code reuse, so modules for code reuse, you know, functor. Local reasoning, it means you just worry about the implementation of your module, right? Modularity, you open, and you create a scope. So these are the keywords for this lecture, okay?